Greetings everyone, welcome to Fishing Planet. My name is the Lady and today I'm going to show you guys how to catch the white bass here in our Rocky Lake, Colorado. So as you can see right now I have one on the line. It's close to 400 grams, nearly 27 centimeters, and it gives us 6 experience points. We're going to keep this. So now there are two ways to fish for the bass. Either float fish or lure fishing. First off, I'm going to show you guys where to float fish for these. So right now, if we take a look at the map, I'm fishing at Trout Galore, and there's a path actually that you can walk between Trout Galore and Fantastic, and you can catch the bass in both spots. In particular, this area right here, alongside the shore, there's reeds there, as you can see. So here we have reeds, some rocks, poles sticking out, and then some reeds again. And here is the fantastic spot. So for float fishing, I'll show you guys my setup. So here we are. I'm using the OmniFloat 450. I'm using a Wincast 2500. Now this is a level 11 reel. The reason for that that I'm using is it can overcome the snags that you can have in this area, whereas let me check, this reel, the Clisso XS1400, cannot always recover from the snags, and you break your line quite a lot more. So you need a level 11 Wincast 2500 reel to overcome the snags, but otherwise it's all below level 11, the gear. So I'm using fluoro open 2mm line. I have a chubby bobber, oval bobber works as well, but not on every bait type. I'm using hook number 2. You can also catch them on hook number 6, hook number 4, hook number 1. 1.0 becomes a bit too big for these bass because they're not that huge in size. Depth wise, you can catch them between 50 centimeters and 125 centimeters. Right now I'm fishing at 75 centimeters. And that's pretty good. I'll already show my catch of today. So here we have the white bass. Now I started out with red worms, and you can catch them, but you also catch a whole bunch of other fish with it. So a crappie, golden shiners, all types of penfish, white sucker as well, and even young cutthroat trout. So it's not a guarantee that if you use red worms, you'll catch constantly bass. And the same goes for using crickets. There's also penfish that like crickets a lot. And there's flies. You can catch white bass with flies too. But then again, you also get some more penfish. And lastly, I use night crawlers. And I get more bass with night crawlers, but also the occasional penfish. There is, however, one type of bait you'll only catch the white bass with, and that's shrimps. However, these only become available at level 17, so when you're not level 17 yet, you are forced to go with either the flies, or the red worms, or crickets, which are common currency. And then night crawlers, they work pretty good as well, but those are gold currency. So anyways, I'll show you guys the spot. So where I like to fish is, we have this reflection of trees, and I like to fish in the gap of it, between 11 and 12 centimeters, 12 meters out, sorry, between 12 and 9 meters out is where I like to fish the most. White bass does take its time. Not sure if I'm going to hook a white bass right now with night crawlers, because I can also attract certain types of penfish with it. But right there we have some movement. It doesn't do a sudden strike. The moment that happens, you're almost sure you either got a trout on it or a sucker. And here we have a golden shiner. So, but that right there is the spot I like to fish on. And like I said, there's also a second spot, so we can take the route through here. You can also use the map to go to Fantastic, come on. Yeah. So what I do is I try to stand close to the rock over there. And then here we have the reflection of this tree in the water, and that's the spot that I try to fish for the white bass on this side of the lake. Not so much close to the reef, because I've found out that here you get a whole lot of bluegills swim here, black crappies swim here, trophies of those two types too. And then there's a whole lot of penfish. I'll show you guys with shrimps, because like I said before, that's the only bait available for the white bass that will guarantee you to actually catch the white bass. And here I too fish between, say, 12 meters and 9 meters. So let's stick it to 10. Now we just need to wait. I prefer to fish on this side of the tree. So there we have some action already. And this is actually a pretty quick one. Normally it takes more time. But there you go, a white bass. So that's it for float fishing. Now let's go to lure fishing. So there's several types of lures that work for this bass. You can I forgot to bring my jig heads with me on this particular trip, but I tested earlier, and jig heads with shads work pretty good. Stick with number one or number two, and color wise, if it's a cloudy day, use the darker colors, and if it's a bright day, use the bright colors. There's however one jig that guarantees you to catch a whole lot of white bass, and it's the mini bass jig. So here I have a mini bass jig number two hook, the 5 gram. That works very well on these fish. So here we go. As you can see, I've caught 3 on them. So that's pretty good. So let's go back to the setup. Right here I'm having a value spin 190. Again, the wing cost 2500 because it can overcome the snags. And then fluoro open 2 millimeter line. And then the mini bass jig, 5 gram number 2. Now again, you can use both sides of the lake to fish for these. What I like to do is cast out between 25-26 meters, about there. Now there are several techniques that you can use. So you can do a lift and drop, you can do a stop and go, that works pretty good as well. Twitch works too. I myself, I prefer either the lift and drop or the stop and go. So you just set your reel speed to 3. And when lure fishing for these, I like to focus on the reflection of this tree and then this tree, and I in general use this area to cast in a bit there, and then make the lure has either one of those two trees, because I found that on this side you have a whole lot of snag points. So there's a log, there's a few rocks on the water that will make you snag. Now when you pass the 10 meters, don't start to reel in fast, because right here at 8 meters there's still white bass. So what I like to do is reel into about 4 or 5 meters, and then continue. So that's from here. Now if we go to the other side, so Trout Galore, which is over here, so I'll stand a bit in the middle. And then we have this cluster of 3 trees that you see right here, and what I do is I throw towards the second tree, and then I angle my rod a little bit, so we will pass for the third tree, this one as well. So there we go, just like so. So I'm angling my rod slightly to Or is this tree? Let's get rid of some slack on the line. There we go. So. But now I'm doing a lift and drop. Four times for the bass. Oh, there we got one. Times for these bass. It's the same with smallmouth and largemouth bass. You really like to. Nice fish. You really like to fish in the early mornings and then late evenings. So right now I'm on an overcast a day. And so I started at 5 a.m. And right now it's. A quarter to nine in the morning, so my suggestion is to fish until say about 10 for the white bass, and then in the afternoon start again at say 3 or 4 p.m. and then fish until 9. Those are the best times that you can go off the bass. Okay, so let's check. Let's sort by type. Okay, so here we have the white bass. They don't give a whole lot of experience, and reward wise it's even more sad. So you get $2. I don't have one of $1 or $3, and experience wise it's between 6 points and 8 points in total that you'll get for this fish. So not a really rewarding fish to go after if you're interested in either grinding money or leveling up. For instance, if we let me go up a bit, where did I have the white sucker? Here we go. So the white sucker, for instance, it gives a reward of $6 with an experience of 33. You really want to go after this fish if you want to level up. Here in Colorado, this one is the one that gives you the most experience. As you can see, penwish fish reward you even more, the double amount. And let's see, here we have the trout. So these are all young ones. I think that has to do with the hook that I used in number two. Their reward is not very high, young cutthroat trout, but the moment you start to catch a general cutthroat trout, which also happens with flies and red worms and crickets and night crawlers, stuff like that, you'll see that experience goes up and money goes up as well. So, that's the story for the white bass. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like, please subscribe and feel free to leave a comment below. See you later. Bye bye.